Usually teams are so aggressive on that sideboard.
And now Chychrun, he scores! Jacob Chychrun!
That is just horrible. Look at the movement here by the Coyotes. Now they're going to pick him apart on the other side. Everybody picking Flowers. Chychrun all alone in the high slot. Johnson has to push right to left. He's off his mark. And Jacob Chychrun, a dart top corner right through Parayko, who screens Johnson on the...
Schmaltz holds, drops it to the front. Keller! And he scores!
Up the ice they go. The St. Louis Blues, a bad line change. And Schmaltz just takes it, finds Clayton Keller like he's done since the minute he got here. And Clayton Keller finds the back of the net for the third straight time in three games for Clayton Keller.
This one bounces in. Fisher's around it. Now Fischer tried the wraparound. Coyotes all over the crease. They're swatting away at it. They score! Christian Fischer, I believe, will get this one. It's a 3-1 game.
And it's a yard sale. The Coyotes win a draw. We talk about the importance. And look at the Coyotes crashing the net. The wraparound by Fischer. He would not be denied. Look at the bodies. Fish out of water. Chad Johnson doing his best to get a hold of this puck. The Coyotes hounding it. Fischer somehow finds it. And it finds the back of the net just over top of the right shoulder of Chad Johnson. That's a huge goal.
Over the line, here's a chance. Step on across. They score! Nick Cousins has made it a 4-1 game.
Coyotes spreading the love around. The long pass off Archibald to Derek Stepan. That's a beautiful pass. Little saucer pass up and over the stick of the defender. And Cousins does the red.
Deflected over the top.
Shot by Ponick.
And now hit a Strozer right to the net. Rebound, they score, and it's Ponick on the follow-up. And that makes it 5-1 Arizona.
Fake shot by Ponick. He misses that on purpose. Why? Because he knows Oliver Ekman-Larsson is sniffing right behind him. What a play. Hit a Strozer, takes it to the net. Ponick follows up, and he buries it. Great job by Hinostroza. Elevation by Ponick. Sees the ice extremely well.
Keller, now Keller across, they score! What a setup!
Clayton Keller inside under the stick of Edmondson. He's not done there yet. Dirty toe drag on Bomeister and the roof job. Goligoski. All he does is put it in a wide open net. Look at that move. Under the stick, head up the entire way. There it is. Nope, see you later. And the finish by Goligoski. Look at the head. He loves it.
And with Clayton Keller, Clayton, it was so critical that you guys find a way to carry that momentum that you built in Minnesota and then, of course, to Nashville, Tennessee here tonight. How did you do it?
I think just getting pucks deep early, and when we do that, good things happen. Threw some pucks on net, and it's good to see some goals go in as well.
That new line, clearly loaded with skill. You guys have been magic since you've been put together. What works? Why is it working?
Yeah, Schmaltz is a skilled player. He likes to move the puck and get it back, and he's got good hockey IQ, so he's someone that I love to play with.
I have to ask you about the play that you made to Alex Goligoski. Can you just tell us about that play?
Yeah, Schmaltz makes a good play in the neutral zone, not just dumping it, kind of being patient with it, gives it to me, and I was able to make a nice move, and Goose going down on the back door there and put it in the back of the net.
Looked a little harder than that. Congratulations. Enjoy the night, Clayton. Thank you.
Thank you.
Aiden, we were all sort of wondering if you guys were able to carry that momentum on the road to here. It looked like you did.
We carried that momentum from Minnesota through Nashville right to this game here at home. It was a great performance again by the guys. We wanted to play a fast game, and I think we did exactly that.
How about for you? It's 1-0 after one. The game's still hanging in the balance. How did you feel about your play?
I thought I had a good game, but once again, our team did a great job boxing guys out, letting me see the puck. I feel like I would have liked to control a couple more rebounds there, but the guys did a good job clearing them when I did let them out. And it was an unreal game by the guys again.
What happened on the goal?
I was reading shot with a one tip in front, and it was a slap pass backdoor to the guy, and it was a good play, and yeah, maybe I can read that in the future, but yeah.
What's it been like in the last few days for you? Now, you knew you were going to get that start, you got the start, all of a sudden there's a travel day, you come back, it's preparation time at the National Hockey League level. What has it been like?
It's been fun. I mean, I've just been living in the moment day to day, and just focusing one day at a time, putting out the best effort I can, and I'm loving it here, so it's been a good time. The team's been really good to me.
Getting kind of used to this NHL thing?
Still new, but I can definitely get used to it for sure.
Any idea how long it's going to last? Do you know?
No clue. We're just one day at a time.
Okay. Spread the wealth around all night, didn't you?
Yeah, it was just about everyone kind of had a point there or did something to contribute. So great win. Hilsey once again played really well for us. And we're just trying to keep this thing rolling.
I know the matchup. You guys have speed. They don't have a lot of it. But when did you realize as this game was beginning that it was going to be a huge advantage?
I think kind of after the first period, we knew they played yesterday, and a lot of us watched or saw highlights. They went to overtime, a really, really hard fought game, and we know that's our identity, is our speed. So that was exactly what we did tonight. We used it really well, and they just got too tired.
Around the net, there you were. That's where you have to make your living, right, Christian?
Yeah. Hockey just funny. Sometimes you get bounces, sometimes you don't. And today just seemed to go my way and a lot of people's way. So it was good to contribute.
How hard was this?
The fact that it's been since October 23rd. I mean, you get a hat trick in there.
Yeah.
All of a sudden it dries up.
Yeah, I know. It's like I said, it's kind of funny. I mean, sometimes you get all the bounces in the world. Even last year, I went through a little bit of drought there, and you try not to think of it, but, just kept sticking with the same routine, didn't really change anything up. I knew it was a matter of time, and today it happened today, so I'm happy to get out of the way, that's for sure.
Christian, what do you think about the way Adin Hill's played, not just tonight, but all three games that he's been in there?
Yeah, to come in and kind of give us that, calmness that he's provided. When other teams had chances, he's done a tremendous job in both games he's played. So, I mean, it's fun to see. Obviously, he's a really young kid and definitely a bright future with him.
So what about that top line and how does that trickle down to the rest of you guys when it's clicking like it is, the skill set that they have and the attention that other teams must have towards them?
Yeah, I mean, that's a really good line. Obviously, all three of those guys I'd classify them as superstars and can make plays at their own will. And like you said, it forces the other team to make sure that they got to play another top line against or another top D pairing. So that kind of, maybe freezes a little space for other lines too. And but when they're clicking, it's unbelievable. They're real dangerous.
Do you guys feel like you owed something, not just to yourselves, but maybe to the fans here after the way that last homestand ended?
Yeah, we obviously had two different type of homestands here in the first couple months of the season. So that was good to get the fans back. It's kind of what they deserve. And it's fun wearing these jerseys on Saturdays. And tonight was obviously a good win, but obviously we care about the fans. They come out and support us. And it's so much easier to play when they're rowdy out here.
Jody, thank you. Rick, we were wondering out loud on the pregame show, would you guys carry momentum from the road to here? You did. How did you do it?
Well, we had some urgency. I was really proud to, it's coming off the road. It's two tough buildings to play against. Coming home, we haven't played well at home in the last, few games, and I really like the focus level on the players. And, 1 through 21 guys were contributed tonight.
You had a competitive advantage. They played last night in altitude, but you also had something else. You had speed. They didn't have an answer for that, did they?
No, I mean, listen, they played a great game last night. They emptied the tank, and we thought if we could get on them early, that was the game plan. Space plays, use our speed.
How about that top line and the way you have it configured now? How blessed are you with that? Every night you're rolling out one of the highest skilled lines I've seen in a long time.
Yeah, Nick's really added a lot of poise. His lateral movement with the puck, it's something we needed. He controls the play. A lot better movement on the power play tonight. We had about 15 or 16 shots on it, so that was nice. Kells was really good tonight. Alex looked good tonight too. So, yeah, in all lines. I mean, every contributed, but that was obviously nice.
In particular, guys like Fischer, Ponick, Cousins, and long extended droughts. How did they figure their way back into this tonight?
Well, the one thing is, if you look at all the goals, they're around the net. Fishes, Pans, and it wasn't so much, they got the goal in front, which is great. There was always somebody there, occupying space. It's hard to score in this league when you play perimeter hockey, and you know they earned their goals tonight.
Aiden, it looks like you're just watching this guy gather confidence and steam. But what about the chances allowed in front of him? How pleased are you in that end?
Yeah, no, we locked it down pretty good. I really like our defensive performance from obviously. Even though second period in Minnesota, even though you know they had a lot of puck, it wasn't like we gave them a lot of shots, but they had puck possession. Since that, our breakouts are so much better than they were 2 weeks ago. The last three games, we were really breaking out well, and we're sticking to the system, and guys are buying in.
Final note: he looked like he was in extreme pain. Yeah. Do you have anything on Michael Grabner at this point?
I don't. I just try to get in touch with him. And, you know, he's with doctors, so we'll see what happens.
Thanks, Rick.
Thank you.